to Voodoo Whiskey Gaming, and this is my late review of the End of Zoe DLC for Resident Evil 7. I played it on the Xbox One, it's also available on the PS4 and PC. So while the title says it's the End of Zoe, you actually play as Joe Baker, Jack Baker's brother, who is like a swamp man, essentially. He does not live in nice houses, he just kind of lives in a shack out in the swamp and hunts gators. Crazy shit has occurred, he finds his niece Zoe, and she's all messed up, because this takes place well after the first game, and actually after Chris had come in the Not a Hero DLC. But Joe is kind of a badass, because he just punches the shit out of things. Like, that is how he handles things. He basically gets his niece, he kidnaps a guy from Umbrella, and tries to find out what was going on. He finds out that there is a cure for her, and he goes looking for said cure. He runs into Molden along the way, and he boxes the shit out of those guys. He also then runs into what is essentially the boss of the DLC, which is this weird, like, mutagenic thing, and it likes to go fisticuffs as well. That having been said, I actually did enjoy the story. It was fairly interesting, and, I mean, it wasn't amazing, and it was fairly short, but it was enjoyable. As for the audio is really good in this game, and they do a good job voicing Joe, and, well, just in general, the sound effects are well done. That's par for the course at this point. As for the gameplay mechanics, it's once again first person. Like I said, no guns, he just punches, man. Left and right trigger, those are your punches. You can put together combos, and he beats the shit out of Molded. I will say that to an extent, I didn't feel like it worked great, because, I mean, you gotta get close to the Molded, and you still can only take so much of a beating. So you gotta play really smart, you gotta play much more cautious than you'd like, and when there's groups of Molded, it gets stupidly difficult, because while you can guard and that will help you, I mean, that only does so much when there's three Molded attacking you. It doesn't leave you a lot of opportunity to strike back and actually defeat them. Some of the larger, harder Molded, that's messed up, especially the ones that spew the acid, because they can spew it through things like a mausoleum. Like, it's on one side, I'm on the other, and it somehow hits me with the acid through the mausoleum. That's messed up, and that made that fight way harder than it needed to be. As for the controls did work very well. The fighting was good. I do think it lacked a dodge feature. That's what it really needed. That would have made it a better system. I don't know what button they would have mapped it to, nor do I really care. It's something that they needed to think about and put into the game. While you can guard and that is useful, it was not as useful as a dodge feature would have been. But other than that, the controls worked well. Lastly, the graphics. Again, it's Resident Evil 7. Resident Evil 7 looked good. The DLC looks good. There's no reason it wouldn't look good. I mean, if it didn't look good, that'd be super weird and extra shitty. At the end of the day, I really enjoyed this DLC, but once again, I don't know why it came so late. It's not long enough that you're like, oh, this needed to take this long. Maybe this is the DLC that held off, like, the Not a Hero DLC, but that's just stupid, because if that is the case, why not release the Not a Hero DLC, which was supposed to come out 9 months ago? Like, I would have been happy had they, like, released that and then waited a while and released this. That would have been awesome. So once again, if you have the Deluxe Edition or Season Pass, whatever, and you already get this, then yeah, go ahead, play it, enjoy it. But if I had to pay money for it, I don't think I'd be down with that. So in the comments below, why don't you tell me if you're a fan of the idea of trying to punch Molded to death. And as always, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please hit that like button, and if you like what I'm doing in general, share, subscribe. Have a good one.